Good Sunday morning, YouTube, and thank you for joining me again for another episode with Gear Swiftly. And we're going to do something a little bit different today. We've done it for a little bit. We're going to do seven cards I'd like to see reprinted in 2020's Mega Tin. Now, a lot of the stuff that we see is stuff that's always easy to speculate because it's like, you know, it's in these sets anyway. I do touch on a card that is technically in one of these sets, but I think it's just because it's deserving of a reprint that people probably don't think of. But with that being said, let's jump into the video. And as I always ask, please leave a like, comment, subscribe. Share if you can, every little helps, and yeah, we'll see you in the video. So, let's start off with Zodiac Chocodyne. It's essentially like the only expensive piece of the puzzle for Zodiacs now. Otherwise, the deck is essentially very, very cheap. Every other card is under like £2 right now. You can pick up like the whole deck core for this set for like, I want to say like 30-ish quid. And it's just Chocodynes basically. Three Chocodynes are going to cost you sort of around about £8 to £10 currently. Average market prices here now is like around just over €10, so yeah, we posted you're probably looking around about the maybe 13 to 14 mark per card. With the Tribal Raid coming out in Phantom's Rage, which is our full set, which I think is like November for us now. Yeah, so like it's a card that's going to be played. It's a card that people are going to want to play. It's a free of in that deck. You can only play two, but I think a lot of people like to play it safe and play free with this one. It's a fantastic card. It just doesn't have a reprint. It's literally got the only printing in Maximum Chaos, as we can see. So this is why the price is getting driven upwards. And by the by, you can actually play a fully holo Zodiac deck now, depending on how the Tribal Raid come out. I'm hoping that they come out as at least like supers, not just commons. At least I'm hoping that's the case. So, second of all, I'd like to see a Winged Dragon of Ra Sphere Mode reprint. Yes, I know we got one in Dual Power a few years ago, well, 2 years ago. Yes, I do know you probably pick them up quite cheap on the market. It's not essentially the reason for why I want this in there. It's just to continue the support that we're getting more support for Ra, with Rage of Ra coming out after this set. We've obviously got Jinzo support coming out in Ra's the Duelist. We also have Harpies coming out in Ra's the Duelist. I think we have that weird Time Wizard Magician thing coming out in Ra's the Duelist, as well as the 100 Dragon, because it's not quite an old 1,000 Dragon yet. He's just a little bit older than he was moments ago, 100. But yeah, I like this to be in the Mega Tins, just sort of, again, to sort of push out more and more, you know, support for Rage of Ra. And then we're going to have a Frightfur Kraken. This is, like, one of the only Frightfurs, I think, that only has, like, the one printing of it, or the only one Frightfur monster that you actually want in your extra deck that you can actually happily use. There are a lot on the market. They're not massively expensive. It does only have the one printing, which is in secret rare, so at least it looks nice. But we've obviously the fright first archetype getting support in Ra's the Duelist with new imp cards, as well as the new fright for monster. I can't remember what it is now. I think they're also getting some support cards as well. I think you get like a trap card that does like extra toy vending machines, or it's a spell card that activates your toy vending machines. I don't know a lot about this archetype. I just know that it's getting more support. We just had a little bit of support in Toon Chaos with Fluffle Angel, which will then bring me on to the next thing I want to look at, which is Fluffle Wings. Again, only has the one printing. Obviously, Fluffles and Edge Imps are part of the same archetype. That evil seamstress is there with the evil clothery to make evil fusion monsters, because kids don't like clowns. I'm not really sure what the whole idea about having evil tools are to make evil toys, but there we go. We actually got the Dimension of Chaos printing. It's only in common. This would obviously look very nice in a higher rarity. It's not, as again, not all these cards are very expensive, but I think it's the idea of having cards that would like to be upgraded. I'm sure that a lot of Fluffle players out there, the 32 of them out there, would generally like to have this on ultra or super rare. You're not getting a secret rare. I'm really sorry, but that's not going to happen. So yeah, ultra rare or super rare would be really good, just to upgrade this thing and look a little bit better. Actually, I can see why this thing looks evil. Look at these weird looking nipple eye things. Oof. You grabby hands. But yeah, I think the Kraken would be a good reprint. I think the Fluff would be a good reprint, just as they would submit themselves. There's a few different Sabers out there. I think we're getting a new Saber Edge Imp tool in Ra's the Duelist, which is kind of like the only one you really want to use then, because of how good it is. Necro Slime. It does have three other printings. This is one of the few cards on this, I suppose, viewing that I've chosen. I think it just looks nice in a better rarity. It's got like a weird starlight pattern that looks... I believe this is just also a common. And I think this is also a common. So it could do with just, again, a rarity bump, maybe to super, maybe to an ultra. It's not getting a secret. I'm really sorry. It's not going to happen. But yeah, obviously for the DDs and the DDDs who've just got their bulky man back with the Link Monster we got earlier in the year in Dual Overload, it did have a little bit of a price sort of jump. At one point these were going for like £3 or £4 each. Obviously the demand has far outweighed the need to play these things anymore. The supply must be very high, as there's 1,180 of these things on card market just to obviously upset the thing. But yeah, I think this would look nice in an upgrade. Same with possibly Lima. I'm not sure if Lima has any of us. Let's have a quick look. When I spell it, I'm so sorry. D. There you go. Thank you. Thank you for remembering things, brain. She's literally only got the one, but she is a super. She's a super rare. I believe this is also in the decks that people use. So she's got the one printing, in all fairness. She could also do then with the next printing, possibly in a Battle of Legends. Price this like English. They're not massively expensive. But yeah, probably could do with a reprint. Probably as a common, knowing what they're going to do. They don't always upgrade supers into ultras. It's normally the other way around. Supers into commons. But yeah, anything that really helps the DD engine so people can play more of it, it's not so bad. I mean, if you're into your big bad monsters that are named after war heroes and war generals and genocidal maniacs from real world and real life, this deck's for you, you crazy man. And Buster Dragon, Breaker of Shadows. I think this is like the most expensive card in Breaker of Shadows. It's not massively expensive. It's only like, the last one sold was like 12, 6, 9 giggity. In English, looking at 10 in near mint condition. So yeah, they're not massively expensive. But I think it'd just be nice for a reprint. We also got, obviously, we just got the reprint of the Buster Dragon. So they've got an ultra rare reprinting. I'm not saying this needs a secret rare or super rare printing, but I think if it was just get reprinted just as an homage, it would be quite nice. But I don't think that's necessarily needed. And this is the one I was saying that's probably more likely than not going to be reprinted anyway. It's Rocket Synchron. Yes, there's literally 3,000 of these in the market, and I do apologise for this number. When I did look at it, I did see how large there was of a supply of this card. But it would be nice if this card got a rarity upgrade as well. Super rare, ultra rare. I don't think you'll be a secret rare, are you? Sorry, but a super rare ultra would be really, really nice. But yeah, it's obviously a key component in the Dragon Links decks, which is one of the best sort of, I'm going to say, rogue decks currently. I can't class it as a meta deck. It's not, you know, it's not Adamancipate, it's not Eldritch. And by like tier 0, tier 1 meta decks, I do mean literally just the only two meta decks that are like continuously just being thrown out there and being like, these are the two best. Dragonlynx is superb. Shadol is still a really good deck. Dinosaurs are still really good. Altergeist, even before the bringing of the Numerons, was still a decent deck that could be played. Skystrikers, as we saw, is still an actual playable deck. So it's not as though there aren't any other decks out there. It's just literally the fact that so many people are just playing these two archetypes at the moment. But yeah, Dragonlink could obviously do with some more upgrades, be it even if it's just rarity upgrades. But yeah, these are the 7/8 things that I'd like to see reprinted in the Megatins. Now, I'm not saying they're going to be worth anything in the Megatins. It's like, for instance, like Solomon Great Gazelle or Solomon Great Sunlight Wolf. The days where they were expensive cards was long been gone, but they got upgrades into ultra rarity in Battles of Legends, which then just makes it nice for people to actually play those decks. So if you are a Salamon Great player, and you're going to go, you know what, it's going to cost me like 20p to buy myself a Salamon Great Gazelle, and then maybe like £3 or £4 just upgrade my super OP10s to ultras, then, and that's the only deck you play, you do that, you know. Bling wins games. I don't say that very often, and I probably shouldn't say that, it's very corny. But yeah, I do agree that we do sometimes need just to have a little bit of shine when we can. But I think that's it for today, guys. Thank you for joining me today. Hope you've enjoyed yourselves on this wonderful episode of Akito Talks Nonsense for 10 minutes. But yeah, leave comments. Tell me what you guys want to see in the Mega Tins that we shouldn't expect in there. I've not obviously anything from Savage Strike, Dane, I'll say Chaos Impact, and Rise and Rampage. The guaranteed to have cards from those sets in there. I'm going to be honest, I don't think we're going to see anything from the Duelist packs anytime soon. I'm pretty sure that if Season 1 sold as well as I feel like it did sell, there's a good chance we're going to see them do Season 2 and Season 3. So I don't think we'll be seeing like upgrades to our Elemental Hero decks with, you know, reprints of Adjusted Gold or Malicious Bane. But yeah, so thank you for watching. Hope you guys have had a good time. But as always, peace out. You guys have a very relaxing Sunday. Goodbye.